Hello friends, this is Rajiv Sharma with you with the world news roundup on coronavirus. Well, the biggest story of the day is the United States. The total number of cases of COVID-19 in the US today surpassed 300,000 mark, with over 8,000 deaths. But that's not all. President Trump has come up with a bizarre remark. He has said on record just a little while ago that he fears a lot of death in next week. This is really painful. Looks like that the US is losing the war against coronavirus. But at the same time, there seem to be happy reports, positive reports about the corona vaccine being available shortly for commercial use. Well, we will have to say, we will have to hold our breath on that. Another cause of concern country is Japan. Japan seems to be on the brink of a deluge in the new cases. Tokyo, for example, has reported 130 new cases today. The largest spike in one single day. This is something to be seen with a lot of trepidation, because Japan is one country which had so far consistently refused to deal with the situation with an iron hand. Now, I think they will have to revise their policies and strategies. As of today, the figures released by Johns Hopkins University, the total number of cases in the world have exceeded 1.2 million, with 65,700 deaths. But the bright spot is that 2,46,000 people have recovered. Now, in Africa, two countries, Ethiopia and South Sudan, have reported their first cases of COVID-19. This is, in fact, these are not the cases, confirmed cases, these are the first deaths in South Sudan and Ethiopia. Spain recorded 674 deaths today. But the positive side is that for the third consecutive day, the daily death toll of Spain is on the decline. For the third day in a row. Now, another positive sign is countries like France, Italy, Germany, Australia, and Spain also, they are showing that the virus is on a flattening now. The curve is flattening. But Iran continues to be a cause of concern. 150 deaths in past 24 hours. Total death toll in Iran, 3,603. Now, another, I would come to the end of this bulletin with a positive news. And this is how the world should deal with this challenge, coronavirus. UAE, for example, the United Arab Emirates, the cabinet today approved strengthening strategic stockpile in risk to deal with the coronavirus, the challenge posed by the virus. Though they have not specified what are those goods which are included in the strategic stockpiling. But the more important decision taken, announced by UAE, is doubling the stimulus package. Earlier they had announced a stimulus package to revive the economy worth $35 billion. Now the package today stands double to $70 billion. Now friends, let me nearer home. In Maldives, for example, the 5-hour curfew in the evening from 5 p.m. to 10 p.m., which is enforced since April 2, doesn't seem to be working. Why? The reason? The curfew, though, it's not in the entire nation, entire archipelago nation. It is only in the Malay region. But as soon as the curfew ends, people come out in hordes, negating the gains of the previous 5-hour exercise. So if this continues, the Maldives government may be mulling over enforcing a 24-hour curfew. Well, so far there are only 19 cases in Maldives. But don't forget, the Maldives is a very small country, a population of 4 lakh. A GDP of just about $4 billion. So 19 cases in out of a population of 4 lakh is also sizable. Now, let me end this bulletin with a freak development. As I had told you in the earlier videos, Philippines president had come up with a unique threat of that he had warned that lockdown has to be enforced, lockdown has to be respected, and he has said lockdown on lockdown. He had threatened that violators will be shot. This is what has happened today. A 63-year-old who was apparently drunk, he was stopped at the police checkpoint, and there he came out, he flipped out his scythe and tried to attack the police, and he was shot. Now, lockdown enforcement is very important. UK today, for example, the United Kingdom today also has underlined the need for this. And UK has in fact warned today that if things continue like this, we will have to think of stricter measures. So friends, here I close. And if you like this video, I would urge you to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.